We need to wait for the radio to come up. We need backup.
We don't have time for that. We gotta move now.
Now!
Rick. Hey, Rick.
Sorry, I was just thinking.
So, Rick, I spoke to your wife on the phone last night, and she seemed very worried. It seems that you're having problems sleeping at night.
That Donna's always worried, but I don't really need to be here, but if it makes her feel better.
You know, Rick, there's nothing to be ashamed of. I mean, there's many guys like you that I see are having the same problems as you. This kind of thing is pretty normal. You know, you seem a little on the edge. Do you need some water? Can I get you something to drink? Anything?
No, I don't want any water. I just want to get out of here as quickly as possible. I got to meet the boys at the pub, so I don't want to be late.
Indeed, Mr. Paulson. Why don't we start from the beginning, shall we?
You are about to embark upon the great crusade toward which we have striven these many months. The eyes of the world are upon you. The hopes and prayers of liberty-loving people everywhere march with you. In company with our brave allies and brothers in arms on other fronts, you will bring about the destruction of the German war machine, the elimination of Nazi tyranny over the oppressed peoples of Europe, and security for ourselves in a free world. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well-trained, well-equipped, and battle-hardened. He will fight savagely. I have full confidence in your courage, devotion to duty, and skill in battle. We will accept nothing less than a full victory. Good luck, and lest us all beseech the blessings of Almighty God upon us on this great and noble undertaking.
I should have some cigarettes right now.
Sarge, we got them all on the run. We've cleared this entire forest.
Are you done, Brown?
Yes, Sarge.
Alright, I've already briefed you on our new mission. Okay, we gotta capture that jackass, okay, before anyone else gets their hands on him. I'm already upset we got three guys right now to this whole operation, and that asshole over there is already asleep. So, we gotta just get through this, okay? So stop being such a whiner, okay?
Gotcha, Sarge.
Alright, sleepyhead, nap time's over. Come on, get up, Rick.
How long is that out?
Long enough. We got knocked out during that firefight. We lost a couple men, but, you know, that's their fault.
Alright, Private, shut up. Alright, Rick, I already explained to Gary over here what's going on, alright? So we need you to get up and pack up because we gotta get on the move, alright? I'll explain to you on the way.
So I take it we're not going back to Cologne to be shipped home, Sarge.
Well, at least your brain still works. Of course we're not going home. You're with me right now. Thanks to yesterday's fire, everyone else is dead or probably out scattered somewhere. Because of the 8 inches of snow we got, you can't see any of the bodies, so just keep a lookout for survivors. Yeah, but this is it, Rick. This is the final mission, all right? You have to make it out alive, and then we get shipped home. Alright, hold up here, boys. Alright, so I already filled Gary in, but here's the deal, Rick, okay? There's a Nazi scientist 10 clicks from here, Johann Heckner, okay? We have to secure him before the Soviets do or the Nazis, okay? He's a very high-profile asset We need to get him because he's huge for in terms of making bombs and some of the stuff in the future, okay? They're even saying this guy could somehow get something into space.
Space? Are you kidding me? It's ridiculous.
Shut the hell up, Gary.
No, you shut up.
Fellas, focus, okay? This is a serious operation we have to do right now, okay? We have to head this direction. We're probably going to face much resistance, okay? So keep your eyes peeled also for survivors, okay? Because this is a three-man team doing an op that should be for half a platoon, okay? So we need to get in there. We need to get out. We need to do it quick, all right? So no bickering back and forth. We need to get this done because I want to get the fuck home.
All right, Sarge.
Rick, you can't blame yourself for the action you took. Taking arms and defending your country is nothing bad.
What do you mean I can't blame myself for what happened? I left my family to go to war.
So, how do you feel about that choice?
How do you think I felt standing there in the cold, reading letters about how my wife hates me because I didn't get to experience my son walking for the first time?
Rick, hold on, I'm just going to leave my coat. Wait, it's getting a little warm. I can't quite understand why you're getting angry. I'm just here to help.
Help, huh? You can help by dropping it.
Rick, can you not ignore this?
I said drop it.
Okay, so you were tasked with finding a Nazi scientist by the name of Johann Heckner? How do you feel about that?
It was too cold to think about it. I mean, I was under the sergeant's command, so I was just following orders.
Alright, let's take a break over by this tree over here.
Hands up!
Whoa, we're Americans!
Are you the men heading after Johann?
Yeah, we're friendly.
Friendly.
Just put your hand down,
sure.
Guys.
Yeah, Gary.
Get over here.
This is ridiculous. I've been out here for months fighting German Nazis.
Is that why you don't have any uniform on?
Yeah, that's why. Had to take their gear, guns. I have one clip left in this thing.
Alright, what information do you have? Anything you can give us that helps us?
I lost contact with my patrol over a month ago.
Okay, did you survive the barrage last night then? Did you see any other men come through here?
I heard gunfire, I didn't see anything else.
Last night a German convoy did pass by, and I heard word of the German scientist. He's not very heavily guarded. They're looking to deter forces, or put the forces off to the side, but there are Russians heading for him.
Aw, damn commies.
Yeah.
All right, well, we're gonna have to keep an eye out. That means this could get into a pretty sticky situation because we're not gonna know whether the Russians are on our side on this. There's a word from, you know, high up in the headshed that everyone's going after this guy and he could be a huge deal, so. Yeah, that's really important information. Did you hear anything else from anybody?
No.
Okay. What's your name, Private?
Steven.
All right, welcome to the squad. Steve. That's Gary. He's the douchebag. And that's Rick. Rick's okay. So we're probably going to move out in that direction. Information is really valuable because we should be able to sneak in and hopefully not even have any type of conflict unless right when we are about to take them, and then hopefully we can sneak out. So that's big. So we should get on the move right now.
Yeah, we need to get there. We want to get home. We're here way too long.
So, were you scared?
I had almost died the night before, and about 50 other times before that. So for me, death was inevitable. I was just waiting for it to happen.
Oh, I see. Well, with an attitude like that, I can easily decipher why you were so depressed at that time.
saw men with eyes hanging out of their head. Other men with their guts hanging out, screaming for their mothers, anything to make it stop.
I apologize for the remark, Rick.
No, don't apologize. I just want you to understand one thing. The only way men change is by sacrifice, and that is the only way.
Did I see that? Those are the Russians. We need to get moving, like, now.
Yeah, let's go.
All right.
Lock loaded. All right. So fire at will. Okay. There's a lot of guys around here, so keep your eyes peeled. All right. So let's go. Let's move out.
All right, Sarge.
Yo, this feel good?
Let's go.
Sarge.
Shut up.
Steve, did you get the rest of the bullets out of here?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, I'm gonna drop. There's only a little bit left. All right. You can't be dealing with that right now. All right.
Mr. Dempsey.
Keep your eyes peeled.
So as I was saying before, Johan was only about 10 clicks away from our location. So the sergeant told me to go on the ridge and scout the area.
So-called sergeant told us to scout this area.
All right, Gary.
So, Rick, I've never asked you. You have a family?
Yeah, I got a wife and a kid named Carl. All
right. How's your wife look?
Well, at the moment, she's pretty pissed at me. Last time I talked to her, my kid the other day walked for the first time, so I'm pretty pissed that I'm not home yet.
That sucks.
How about you?
I've come from some shithole in Vermont. You know, hated at my school. Could never get a job, so I decided to join the army. Only option I had.
Yeah, hopefully we can both get out of here.
Yeah, hopefully.
We haven't seen any troops either, so I don't know if they're fighting the Russians right now or where everyone is, but hopefully we can sneak in here, so just keep on the lookout down over there.
Alright, well, it sounds like everything is going okay. Question, did this give you any relief or anxiety?
Not really. It was supposed to be the last mission. And I knew we were going to encounter some heavy resistance. You know, it always seemed like shit hit the fan in the worst possible times. It was great being with all those guys. They were the best guys I could ever ask for. Gary and Steve were always with me through everything. Reddington really showed us great leadership and brought out the best in all of us. Nothing could have prepared us for what was next.
Man, this shit should be down over there to the left, so we should move down.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sarge, I think they blew up the shed.
All right, everybody down. There's gotta be guys in the area.
Damn it! They blew the fucking shed up. You're kidding me.
Listen,
came out here for nothing.
Gary, quiet down.
I will not quiet down.
Shut up.
Gary, there's germs.
Gary, shut up. Gary, I said sit down and shut up. We gotta go look for the body.
No, Sarge. I'm tired of your shit.
So, that's my story, a sacrifice to win. I got back to the post and got shipped home later.
Well, Rick, it does sound like you're truly an amazing person.
No, I'm not amazing. I'm just the product of the people I surrounded myself with. I owed it to them to fix the relationship with my wife and continue on my way, as all men should.
Well, Rick, I'll just look over through my notes again, and we will meet again, this time, next week.
Thank you, Doctor. I'm actually feeling a bit better now.
Yes, and call me if you experience any more, dreams.
Will do, Doc. Thanks again.
Thank you.
things I love. The things I love. The things I love.